Hi everyone, this is Yakir from Arc Intelligence, and in this video we will review the area scatter tool in the environment for Revit plugin. So the area scatter tool allows you to place multiple components on any surface in your model according to the predefined settings. In this example, I will use it to place planting families to create my planting plan, but keep in mind that you can use this tool with any family category you need. Architect, for example, often use the area scatter tool to place furniture in a grid or to place lighting fixture inside or outside the building. In this specific project, you can see that the main design is linked into this file, and I will use it to host the scattered families. Working in a separate file and linking the main model into it can be a good option if you don't want your model to get too heavy on your machine. And luckily, the area scatter tool can work both with live and linked surfaces. Let's go to the Environment tab, and in the Site panel, open the Area Scatter tool. First, I select the placement area. Any surface can be used as an area. You can choose floors, ceilings, roofs, topographies, or all kinds of abstract elements, such as areas, rooms, or zones. You can select one or more areas. Just click on it once to select, or you can click again to deselect. Once you're done, click on Apply Selection. Next, let's choose which family to scatter. You can select any family from the drop-down list or use the pick on screen option to choose any family that is already located in the project. So, let's jump ahead to the scatter settings section now and get back to the advanced selection option later to see how to create a mix of families. You can place the elements according to a grid or you can switch to the irregular method to create a forest effect. In this case, you can control the placement by simply specifying the number of elements you wish to place. At any point of the process, you can click on Apply and see the result without leaving the command. Let's switch the regular method off now, and instead define a placement grid size for a more formal result. You can unpin this clip to set a different height and width size. I'll click on Apply again to see the changes. Another option is to set a triangulated grid where you can define the side length of the triangle. When working with a grid, there are a few more settings that will affect your design. Move the randomizing slider to achieve a slight displacement of the element from the grid. Move the pattern angle slider to rotate the grid to the desired angle. Use the placement level drop-down list to choose any of the levels in your project as the host for the elements, or choose the surface elevation option if you want the environment to automatically identify your host surface and place the elements on top of it. You can also set an offset from level value. This will move elements up or down from the selected level or surface. If you are working with abstract surfaces, such as rooms and areas, you can use the Find My Host option, so that environment will automatically identify an overlapping surfaces as a host for the scatter elements. I recommend to always check the Combine Elements checkbox. When doing so, environment will gather all the scatter elements into an assembly group. This will allow you to go back and modify the scatter after you exit the command. Click Finish to complete the process and exit the command. If we select the elements, we can see that they are all a part of one assembly, since we checked the Combine Elements option. To modify an existing scatter group, open the Area Scatter window again and choose the option to select scatter group. Now just click on the group you wish to edit and click on Apply Selection. You can change the setting of this assembly as you wish. Here's a workflow tip. Just like in this example, you can always create an area plan of your planting design and use the Area Scatter tool to place the plants on top of it. Just remember to check the Find My Host option to find the hosting surface for the plants. So now, as I promised, let's go back and see how to create a mix of scattered elements with the Advanced Selection option. Click on the Advanced Selection button and another window will open. In this window, you can select the elements for your mix. Just like before, you can choose the families from the drop-down list or with the pick on screen option. Click on Add Element or the Remove button to modify the scatter mix. Set the ratio parameter of each element to control the proportion of the mix. If you are using the irregular method, change the size value to set a minimal distance between the scattered elements. If you want to copy an existing mix already created in your model, click on the Get from Existing Scatter Group button and select an existing scatter assembly to copy the exact mix settings. Click Apply to exit the Advanced Selection window and go back to the general scatter settings. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more new videos.